talking about a round robin visa. This is truly a round robin. One beats two, two beats three, three beats one. And here they are playing the final, aren't they? It's like, I think the only difference, of course, was, I don't think, I mean, you could say either, you know, net run rate always comes into play. This was not a net run rate issue. This was a net time rate issue, right? You made a team play, you know, 20 minutes after they finished one game. Yeah, that's not right. That's not right. I know you've spoken about it, and but please.
Yeah, it was. You feel sorry for these players because we've heard already that they've missed so much cricket. They've literally been in their home states, home cities, waiting for the opportunity to play. The India England series got cancelled. Then the IPL started, and they still weren't sure whether this was going to go ahead. So I do commend the organisers for at least getting it up, but then to only have, you know, two games that each team plays, they literally do, you know, 8 days in Mumbai, 6 days in Dubai quarantine, and then they come out and play two games and it's done, the round robins. And you can see that poor velocity, they had to back up after a night game for an afternoon game, and you had just one of those days where things just don't go your way, and unfortunately for them, that meant that they were out. And we've seen also in the men's IPL, players taking a bit of time to get into it, getting the rust, the cobwebs off, and being able to play some great cricket. So I feel sorry for them, but I'm, like we've heard at the toss, no one knows if they're going to play cricket again anytime soon. So that is a real concern.
Yeah. We'll just show you those results again and we'll tell you exactly what we were talking about. The first game, of course, Velocity played that first game against the Supernovas and they beat them. So Velocity beat Supernovas, but then they had to come back the next afternoon. So you finish this game, yeah, 11 p.m. perhaps India time, and you're back again to play an afternoon game the next day. And that's when Velocity was 47 all out. And it's something that, you know, the thing is that, Joy, you know, you've been with the team as well. You know, there's, I mean, we do a live broadcast and the adrenaline is pumping for the next 2-3 hours, right? I mean, let's not even compare that to playing an actual game, a physical, mental, emotional challenge like that. You don't get to sleep till like 5-6 in the morning and then you've got to get on the bus at like noon.
Yeah, absolutely. It's never done to a men's team. In fact, if you see the IPL schedule, you know, schedules used to come to us. If you're playing, traveling the next day and playing the next day, we complain because it's very tough on the teams. Yep. No team will ever take an early flight out. No team will take a flight out before 11 o'clock in the morning, because what happens during the IPL is you essentially become nocturnal guys. Now you're expecting these girls to play. Okay, all that adrenaline. They haven't played a match for a long, long time. Here's their first big opportunity. People are going to watch them. And they finish exactly as you said, 2-3 at night. They're going to get up the next morning. And there's not even time. Even pool recovery will not happen at 11 o'clock, at 12 o'clock at night. You're not even going to recover in the pool. What is even the physio going to do? So, I mean, it's ridiculous. Then the problem is, if that has to be the case, then fortunately, unfortunately, it has to be equal for all teams. Now, basically, the Trailblazers have got a gap. Everyone else has got a gap. Basically, the Supernovas have got a gap. It's these people who caught it in the neck. So, I mean, it's just a bit of a, look, I am exactly with Lisa that I'm really delighted that they're doing this, because, you know, when the England tour was cancelled, I wouldn't even say the England tour was cancelled. Suddenly it was not talked about. People stopped talking about it and, you know, players were calling up and saying, what's happening, you know, when's the camp and all that. Oh, no, we'll let you know. Yeah. So after that, the fact that they're doing this is good, but...
Yeah, it's here's the thing, right? Yes, I know that there's a lot of talk and that's what sort of upsets me a little bit, right? Where you're just doing a lot of talk like, oh, thank God something is happening. But that's just crumbs. I don't think these champion athletes deserve these crumbs.
No, and that's, I guess that's my point. And also the fact that for those that are tuning in for the first time watching women's cricket, and that was my point with the blog, don't judge them on this performance. Just put it all in perspective. So yeah, female players, female athletes have a tendency just to be grateful that they're getting a chance. Now is the time, and based on the fact that India made the 2017 World Cup final for the 50 over, 2020 in March, the T20 World Cup final, they haven't won one yet. So they actually have to go just another level. And the only way that's going to happen is if they have a strong domestic competition. And these matches, the Women's T20 Challenge, we cannot put them in the bundle of this is the Women's IPL. It isn't. because firstly, there's only three teams and they only get to play two games and they're not associated potentially with a franchise. But more cricket at this level will no doubt help these Indian domestic players. So that when they get to the big stage and they get to finals, it's not that big a deal. They just roll with the punches and they can perform